Welcome to the Online Zone. I'm your host, Julio Rodriguez, and today I'm joined on the phone by Joe Udine. Joe, how's it going?
How's it going, Julio? Thanks for having me.
Pretty good. Now, for those of you who don't know, Joe is Houdini10 online, and pretty much got famous for his sick run of rebuy tournaments a couple years ago. Joe, you want to talk about that?
Yeah, that was like kind of right when I got serious about poker. I just I came back from Vegas and I had chopped tournament Bellagio, so I had a role to work with. Deposited online and actually I won like the first F-tops that they had for, it was only like a 2,000 person field because they capped it.
Yeah.
And I actually chopped it with Roland DeWolf, and then I won like. It is ridiculous because now I realize how much variance is involved in the 100 rebuy, but
yeah.
I won it like 3 times in 2 days, which is just retarded. I was definitely running pretty good.
Now, you had a slower start to 2009. It wasn't quite what I'm sure you were used to, but all of a sudden, you get second in the Sunday warm-up, you start final tabling tons of rebuy events, and then you take down the F-Tops event just this week, event number 12, for $300,000. and now all of a sudden you're in 18th place in the OPOI, and you know, you're within striking distance. Is it just one of those things where, okay, it's coming, you just feel like eventually you'll break through this year, or is it one of those where you may have gotten a little frustrated with yourself?
I don't know, it's like a combination of both. Like, I definitely, the start of 2009, it was kind of slow. I don't really know why. I probably wasn't playing that good. I had a few close calls with, like, big money like this, or at least for me, online. I went deep in one of the F-Top's main events and had, like, a lot of chips and in a good spot, and I kind of made a few moves that I probably wouldn't make now. And then I had a deep run at Borgata this summer. I was like third in chips out of 15 left, with a pretty soft field probably. And I should have done a lot better. I got 13th place, so it was pretty disappointing. And I just like, I don't know, it definitely helped me out in this tournament because I kind of knew what to expect when I got deep. And I was more used to playing for that kind of money, and kind of just took advantage of the experience, I guess. And obviously got pretty fortunate a few times.
Now, I want to talk about deep in that tournament. It wasn't a notable final table by any means. I mean, there were a lot of unknowns there.
Right.
And heads up, you made a deal, is that correct?
Yeah, it was with this. I forget his name. It's like Carter 8080, I guess, on Full Tilt. Mm-hmm. But Mole Daddy on Poker Stars. I'd met him like a year ago at Borgata, and I know he plays high stakes heads up singos all day. So it wasn't like a great spot for me to play heads up for like 150K.
Now, can you talk about the new Full Tilt software for Chops?
What's that?
Can you talk about the new Full Tilt software for Chops?
Oh yeah, it was like real easy to do. It was the first time I ever used it. It just does it for you. Like we did like a chip shop since we were so close. We're basically even in chips, like 5 million each, and just did it for us. And then we played for like 17K heads up.
So you're pretty much a fan of the system. What do you say to those players who are complaining, saying this is going to educate the fish, you know, who maybe don't know about ICM chops?
You can still negotiate in the chat. So I think it's pretty commonplace where if a guy thinks he has an edge, that he can negotiate a better deal for himself. And if not, he should just play heads up and win anyway.
That's true. You can always just play it out.
I mean, I don't think it's that big of an issue.
Yeah, there was some talk that, you know, last year's WCOOP main event would never have happened the way it did had this information been available to some of the players who were less experienced. But I say hello. Say hello to your dog. Gotcha.
All right, I just let him out. Sorry about that.
No problem, man. No problem. But getting back to the chops. Sorry, I forgot what I was saying. You're gonna have to edit this one fast. how are we talking about?
W Coop, one of
yeah.
The chop so, on the W Coop. Yeah, I didn't even realize that they did a chop.
It was just a situation where Alex Camberis was able to negotiate himself a very, very good deal despite being pretty short in chips. And
right.
He was up against some people who didn't really know what was going on.
Okay, yeah, I kind of remember.
So, I mean, I guess if you're in that spot, you gotta love the new software upgrade.
Yeah, I mean, you don't have to do an ICM chip chop. Like, you can do a custom chop. We didn't do that, but you can just, like, press the button and, like, negotiate the numbers that you want. So, I mean, that was the first chop I've ever done, I think, because people were trying to negotiate chops when I final tabled the warm-up, and it was just, like, it was a good spot for me. I had a lot of chips, so I was willing to play it out. And then it kind of, like, it helps you out to know that the guys that you're playing against really want to make a deal, because maybe they don't want to risk their whole stack on a crazy four bet or something like that. I don't know.
So you could push them around a little more, knowing they're trying to move
right,
up in the
like
money.
You can pick your spots better.
Gotcha. Now, what's your plan for the rest of the year? You're gonna just keep grinding online? I know you like to stick to the Northeast.
Yeah. I don't know. This is definitely like a pretty good boost to my bankroll. So I would definitely would like to travel out west and play like LA Poker Classic. I know that's not for a few months, but yeah, I'll play W Coop online, and then there's a Borgata Open that kind of, it conflicts actually with the W Coop main event, so I don't know exactly what I'm going to do yet, but I'll probably just chill around the East Coast for now and wait for some bigger stuff to come up.
All right. Well, thanks for joining us on the show today, Joe, and good luck with the rest of the year.
All right, man. Thanks a lot.
I'd like to thank you guys for watching The Online Zone right here on Card Player TV.